Light still shining bright through the sycamore stormy. The newborn eggs in all its fragrance from the fields I used to roam. When I dream about the moonlight on the Wabash, then I long for my Indiana home. My home, sweet home, Indiana.
Now the presentation of the colors by a color guard from Southport High School and our national anthem.
The Bedford North Lawrence Stars and the Minutemen of Concord High School in just a moment. Now this break, one of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance.
As much a part of Indiana as looking for a unique antique. Riding Blue River on a summer afternoon. Strawberry shortcake in June. They're as much a part of Indiana as Farm Bureau Insurance and you.
It's the most eagerly awaited driver's sedan in Pontiac history. Four-door functionality charged with Grand Prix style, performance, and driving excitement.
Get on the Pontiac and ride it! Pontiac ride!
Look it over. Check it out. Try it on. The new Grand Prix Sports Sedan. At your Pontiac dealer now.
Rebuilding Titan Man.
Hills has the right stuff.
You got the right stuff.
baby.
Like New Kids on the Block.
T-shirts.
Night shirts.
Fun stuff. Hills has New Kids on the Block. Cassettes, CDs, and videos. All priced low every day.
Now let's take a look at the school team facts for these two ball clubs. Bedford North Lawrence Stars, located in the southern half of the state. In Bedford, Indiana, you see the enrollment, school colors. Seventh time they've been in the Final Four. This is the first time that Damon Bailey's been able to get his ball club in the championship game. For the Concord Minutemen, they come from the very northeast sector of our state, up in Elkhart, Indiana. Their second Final Four appearance, they were here 2 years ago, but a young man named Sean Kemp led them to the championship game. Kemp never played a single second of college basketball and is now playing professionally for the Seattle Supersonics. Here's the tournament trail. First off, for the Bedford North Lawrence Stars, they won the Seymour Sectional with wins over Brownstown, Jennings County, and Seymour. Then they won the Seymour Regional. And in that second game against Scottsburg, Damon Bailey broke the all-time Indiana career scoring mark. And then in the Terre Haute semi-state, Damon Bailey in that win over Terre Haute North had his season-low 19 points, but he came back with 34 against 7th-ranked Evansville Bossing in the championship game. Now, for the Bedford North Lawrence Stars this afternoon, they were winners over Southport 58-55 in a ball game that saw them down by 14. For Concord, they were winners of the Elkhart Sectional. Goshen, Penn, Elkhart Central, they all fell by the wayside. Then on to the regional, where Bremen and East Noble were beaten. And in the Fort Wayne semi-state, Whitco and Northfield, 14th-ranked Northfield. And then earlier today, Anderson fell by 4 points in a game that was really hotly contested. Now, Tom Heschen, help me here. Team comparison, if you put them on paper, there's not much difference here between these two ball clubs, maybe in the free throw department, and that was big for BNL earlier today.
Well, it certainly was. It's a ball club you want to keep off the free throw line. We have a situation where this afternoon they were 21 of 25 right there. But other than that, it's pretty even, as you can see.
All right, let's take a look now at Damon Bailey. This is the young man who everybody in the nation perhaps is talking about. He was indeed the Naismith High School Player of the Year this afternoon. He had 7 assists to go along with the 25 points and the 10 rebounds that he had. And for the Concord Minutemen, Jamar Johnson is what we were told he was going to be, simply an outstanding basketball player. So there you have a brief look at some of the individual players and some of the ways they got here. Here are the keys to the ball game today, Tom.
Well, Bailey has to get it inside. He certainly is devastating when he gets there. Cut down on the turnovers. They're good ball handlers and control the boards.
And as far as Concord is concerned, they got to keep BNL off that free throw line.
That's right. And you see the other two right there. Of course, Bailey outside. He hadn't shot well out there particularly. And also, they have to try and get that balanced scoring. They had 5 starters in double figures in the game's opening round today.
All right, I'm Jerry Baker, along with Tom Heschen and Hilliard Gates. We'll call the action for you here tonight. Now let's go across the floor and meet the teams. And again, here's Scott Gray.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the championship game of the 80th Indiana High School Athletic Association Boys State Basketball Tournament. Tonight's championship game features the Bedford North Lawrence Stars and the Concord Minutemen. Here are your rosters and starting lineups for the championship game. First, for the Bedford North Lawrence Stars, number 20, Alan Bush. Number 30, Paul Stevens. Number 34, Trent Todd. Number 42, Johnny Mike Gilbert. Number 44, Ryan Boudinier. Number 50, Brent Connor. Number 52, Ethan Cox. And the starting lineup for the 28-2 Bedford North Lawrence Stars, at one guard, a 5'9" senior, number 10, Dwayne Curry. The other guard, a 6'1" senior, number 12, Jamie Cummings. At one forward, a 6' junior, number 22, Chad Mills. The other forward, a 6'3" senior, number 32, Damon Bailey. The center, a 6'2" junior, number 40, Jason Lombrecht. And the head coach of the Stars, Dan Bush. And now the roster and starting lineup for the Concord Minutemen. Number 14, Jim Asuera. Number 20, Matt Stender. Number 24, Ryan Culp. Number 32, Johnny Hackworth. Number 42, Shane Bechtel. Number 50, Bill Eddy. Number 52, Colby Denman. And the starting lineup for the 28-0 Concord Minutemen at guard, a 6-foot senior, number 22, Jamar Johnson. The other guard, a 6'3" junior, number 34, Mike Swanson. At forward, a 6-foot junior, number 30, Jeff Massey. At forward, a 6'2" senior, number 44, Micah Sharp. And the center, a 6'4" senior, number 54, Bill Mutch. The head coach of the Minutemen, Jim Hahn.
The officials for the championship game, Norm Hathcote from Pendleton on the left and Timmy Patterson from Evansville, the taller on the right.
And we'll be back with the championship tip-off in just 1 minute. 1 minute.
Everybody knows that milk's for babies, charming, disarming, whatever they do. Everybody knows that milk's for babies. Wouldn't you know it, baby? Milk's for you. Fine baby skin, strong baby bones, a bright baby smile, and great muscle tone. Wouldn't you know it, baby? Milk's for you. It's a health kick, baby.
At Marsh, our people make the difference, offering beautiful plants and flowers, freshly baked rolls, breads, and pastries, helpful information and recipes for your fresh fish and seafood, and the biggest selection of brand name products you'll find anywhere. You value fast, friendly service, and we, all of us at Marsh, value you.
Here's your lineup, Bedford North Lawrence Stars, 28 wins, 2 losses. Those 2 defeats, by the way, in case you're wondering, came at the hands of Lawrence North, defending state champions, 51-50 in the Hall of Fame tournament down in Bloomington at Assembly Hall, and at New Albany, 60-59. And, of course, Concord unbeaten in 28 games, ranked number 1 in the state by the Associated Press, number 2 by United Press International. Now we're set to go. Tom, your thoughts on what either club may have to do here in the first 5 minutes of this ball game?
Well, I think Concord's trying to try and get it up and down the floor and get the easy basket if they can, and the Bedford North Lawrence is going to play much more cautiously.
Damon Bailey steps in to jump against Micah Sharp, and the opening tip control by Concord. They travel way down from the upper northern reaches of our state. They were here 2 years ago, and they were somewhat embarrassed in the championship game against Muncie Central. They'd like to avenge that, if possible, tonight. And Damon Bailey in blue said one of the, maybe the only thing missing from his great, illustrious high school career was a state championship. We'll check the lineup matchups here in a minute. Here's the long shot, rebounded strong on the near side by Bedford North Lawrence's Chad Mills. That is Bailey, number 32. He will be shadowed this evening by Mike Swanson. Here he is, and there's Swanson. They lob it down to the far corner to Dwayne Curry, who had a great ball game earlier today. Now Bailey gets the move inside, and it's one of the keys that we talked about before the game, would be Bailey out of the middle.
Well, he did get the opportunity to take it down low because they created a one-on-one situation, and he beat Swanson and gets the first 2 points.
First 2 points of the ball game, and here's the ball deflected out of bounds by Bedford North Lawrence. We should be, we would be remiss by not saying, but this is not necessarily an all Damon Bailey ball club. He's got some guys out there who are good role players.
Well, they handle the ball very well, and they go to the free throw line, very effective there, and certainly he had 7 assists this afternoon, so somebody else has to be scoring.
They left a sharp wide open. He missed the shot, and the rebound is taken off inside by Chad Mills of Bedford North Lawrence. Here's Bailey, spinning. And there's one of those feeds we were talking about to Curry, and Curry's got the three.
Well, little Dwayne Curry, 5'9", great senior leadership along with Damon Bailey, and he hits one outside, a three-pointer.
We'll try to develop this more, but one of the great reasons for the Bedford North Lawrence success against Southport earlier today was Dwayne Curry. Not scoring, but defense. He was tough. Shot missed, rebounded by Munch, double, triple team, gets the shot up and off the mark, and he walked with the basketball.
Now, one of the things we had indicated is that Bedford North Lawrence really has to hit the board. Concord did get a second shot that time, but nullified by the walking violation.
And a steal by Micah Sharp and a miss by Sharp. Rebounded by Bassey, but he couldn't hang on, and Damon Bailey does.
I mentioned that Concord team that was defeated 2 years ago in the final game, as you indicated, Chandler Thompson played for Muncie Central in that one, and certainly he's proven his worth with the Ball State this year.
Yeah, they went a long way in the NCAA tournament. Speaking of the NCAA, they played on the same floor a week ago, and they drew in excess of 20,000, but there's 20,000 more than that here today, over 41,000. First couple of points for Concord as they go outside, and Jeff Massey, who is their top field goal shooter with 5 for 10 today, has his first 2 points. It's 5-2, Bedford North Lawrence out in front with 5:40 to go here in the first quarter.
Full court press by Concord, but the Stars get it down and are going to set up their half-court offense. They see the half the floor cleared for Bailey.
And it's interesting, he got weak side help defensively that time. Here's the ball stripped away from Chad Mills and out of bounds to Bedford North Lawrence. The defensive assignment has Mike Swanson, who is a starting guard for Concord, playing defense against Bailey at forward, but that time he got some help down low, I believe, from Jamar Johnson.
It was Jamar Johnson.
And there's the deflection. It'll be saved by Curry. Throwing up court. Here's the breakaway by Johnson. He scores. Jamar Johnson had a good game earlier today against Anderson. He's hit on 7 out of 12 from the field. Finished up with 21 points.
Concord, a team with very excellent athletic skills. Bedford North Lawrence, good basketball skills, which doesn't mean that Concord doesn't possess them. And that's going to make, I think, for a very interesting contest.
Well, it was not an easy route for Bedford North Lawrence to get here. They had to beat some awfully good ball clubs this year. And they got the job done in good fashion. Curry, only 5'9", a senior, is running mate number 22, Chad Mills. And back to Curry and Cummings. All by himself is Bailey. Yes, sir, that's a three for Damon.
Well, very nice pick along the baseline that time, and Swanson got lost in the traffic. And they set it up well and hit Bailey as soon as he made the turn into the corner, and he knew what to do with it from there on.
With 4:35 to play in the first quarter, Bedford North Lawrence leading Concord 8-4. Inside to Much, and he is fouled. The foul will go against number 12, Jamie Cummings, for Bedford North Lawrence. If you're watching for the first time ever, as far as Bedford North Lawrence is concerned, that is a consolidation formed in 1975 of Bedford, Fayetteville, Heltonville, Needmore, Olytic, Shawswick, and Tunnelton. In fact, Damon lives in Heltonville. At the school at Bedford North Lawrence.
Coach Danny Bush played for Olytic High School. An outstanding player.
Played on the team that went undefeated 1 year.
Right.
4 minutes and 22 seconds to play in this first period. Bedford 8, Concord 4.
Chad Mills working there against Jeff Massey. And Cummings has the tough job on Jamar Johnson, who takes that shot.
And got it.
Jamar had 18 for Concord in their championship game loss in 88. There he makes the steal. Took that ball right away from Cummings.
Johnson with a good offensive play and a great defensive play. Makes it a tie ball game for the first time at 8. Concord has yet to lead in this ball game. That's the first tie. No lead changes. 3 minutes and 49 seconds to play. And another three-pointer is up and good by Chad Mills.
Yeah, Chad Mills got his body squared up, and he releases the ball very well. Nice touch. and Mills with his first fielder of the evening.
And of the four field goals made by Bedford North Lawrence, three have been three-pointers. Here's one at the other end that is short, and the rebound is taken down by Bedford North Lawrence's Chad Mills.
Well, the Stars were only one of five from three-point land this afternoon.
Bailey, yes.
On the run, nice concentration, eyes on the hoop, and a very good touch, as we would expect.
And you got to keep in mind now that Bedford North Lawrence, there's a reach-in foul that'll be put on Jamie Cummings. That's his second. Bedford North Lawrence played the second game today, so Concord has had about two and a half hours maybe rest on them. I don't know that that'll be significant, but we'll watch and see if it is. Dwayne Curry going out of the ball game, and Alan Bush, the coach's son, 6'1", 5'10", and a sophomore coming into the lineup.
Well, of the four teams participating here today, three of them played the second afternoon game a week ago and survived it, so it may or may not be a factor. I think if you play well, you solve a lot of other problems.
Here's a great defensive play and a steal by Jason Lombrick, and a steal at the other end by Mike Swanson. Swanson lets the traffic clear. Didn't have the numbers that time. Inside 3 minutes. Nobody went out to get Micah Sharp, and he knocked it home.
Well, Bailey was caught inside that time. He's defending Sharp, but never did get in position. There's another errant pass that Bailey has to swat back inside, and they lose it.
Hackworth is in the ballgame now for Concord. Donnie Hackworth, number 32. Well, they made Johnson change his shot that time. They go the other way. Here's Bailey. Yes, what a soft touch.
Left hand that time. He took it, changed hands. Great defensive play by Jamie Cummings that started all that down at the other end of the court. He deflected the ball, got possession, gave it to Bailey, and he finished it off.
2 minutes, 15 seconds to play. Much on the alley-oop. Missed it on a good lob pass by Mike Swanson. And the foul may be on Much. No, it is on Bedford North Lawrence.
It's going to be on Lombrecht, I believe. No, it's going to be on Much. You called it right the first time. He got behind the man. Much committing the foul, and we're going to have a timeout.
All right, there is Bill. That is personal foul number one. The score with 2:14 to play in the first quarter is Bedford North Lawrence 15 and Concord 10. One of your sponsors is Indiana Bell.
Sometimes you need to talk to a couple of people at once.
Bob, Bill, how about setting a time?
And three-way calling lets you do just that.
What's Ben say?
Huh? Hold on.
With a punch of the receiver button and dialing a new number.
Ben.
Yeah.
Bob's on the line. Hold on. Ben, Bob. When do we do it, boys?
How about now?
Bob?
You bet.
Then we're in business.
Three-way calling. It helps you plan. Or change your plans.
Plan B.
Natural gas is environmentally clean. Natural gas heats. Faster. You are. Thinking. Smarter to choose gas.
Encourage you to stay in the arena.
The Woods, a construction company down in Florida, Naples, Florida, 70 years ago, playing for Bedford, he won the Gimbel Award. I understand you flew in from Florida for this tonight.
Oh, sure. I come up every year.
70 years ago.
Yes.
You won the Gimbel Award.
Right.
Tell me your thoughts tonight.
What?
Give me your thoughts.
Oh, my thoughts? I love to come up here. I never seen anything like this in my life before.
Who's going to win?
Bedford.
Nice to see you. Now back to Jerry.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Hilliard. 2 minutes and 10 seconds to play here in this first quarter of play. Here's Jamar Johnson with the steal on the turnover. And Johnson now with 8 points on four field goals. His average is 19-3, which leads the ball club. And earlier today is Tom Entity at 21. So it's 15-12 now with Bedford North Lawrence in front with a minute and 52 seconds to play. Defensive play and a foul on Jamar Johnson. Nope, they go the other way. Other player down on the baseline is Bechtel.
That's going to be on Shane Bechtel.
Yeah, yes. Shane Bechtel, who did not play in the afternoon game today.
Well, they have Bechtel along with Donnie Hackworth and Chin Asoera also in there with Much, Massey, and Swanson going to the bench here with a minute 51 to play in the first period.
I would imagine we'll see some changes of the guard throughout the night because of the fact this is indeed their second game of the day. Our third. We may have to run a sub or two in here along the way. Chad Mills, 5 for 5. He was perfect at the free throw stripe in that victory over Southport. Now he is 7 for 7 on the day. And he is averaging about 13 per game, about 4.8 per game, and he had 13. The afternoon contest, and off to a good strong start tonight with five.
Well, Lombrecht comes up, tries to cut off the dribble, can't do it, and Johnson gets that shot away, but it won't fall.
Osuera tried the tap-up rebound. It was deflected out of bounds by Bedford North Lawrence. And there is the head man of Concord, Jim Hahn.
Well, they were successful on these inbounds plays this afternoon, and they shake one loose again. Micah Sharp got free. They really gave Anderson fits on that earlier today.
One thing we have not seen that we saw earlier today were those backdoor passes. Well, they were very effective. This is one of the better passing high school teams you'll ever see. Here's a three. Yes, sir. And it's Alan Bush, who is an excellent three-point shooter, and this is the biggest lead of the game. It's 6 points now for Bedford North Lawrence. In fact, Bush set a school record this year in a game against Edgewood. He had 7 three-pointers in the game. That's a school record. That's not a record, but that's a pretty good shot right there out front by Micah Sharp. He has 6 points from that starting forward spot. At the other end, Lambrock is in time.
Lombrecht gets the basket on a heads-up inbounds pass from Damon Bailey. Another assist for Damon.
That'll wear you down. Concord coming up and working for the hoops. They get it, and the first thing you know, they're back on offense again because Bedford North Lawrence has scored in a hurry at the other end.
Boy, that's a nice touch demonstrated right there by Donnie Hackworth.
Hackworth looked up, and there was Damon standing right in his path, and Hackworth very ably pulled up and got the 10-footer. So with 20 seconds to go in the first quarter, 22-18. Bedford North Lawrence with the lead in the basketball.
Hey, both defenses are working extremely hard, and the ball handling has been very good early. The Concord press has been a problem at times.
There's that clear out again, and there's Bailey. Boy, Bailey just got a super shot one-on-one. He got Ken Osuera lined up that time. There's the shot that is shy. Micah Sharp, and that takes care of your first quarter play, and it's everything we were expecting after one. It is Bedford North Lawrence 24 and Concord 18 for the state championship. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance.
As much a part of Indiana as a hoop hanging high on a barn, stop along the way to brighten up a rainy day. Photographs of heroes on display. There is much a part of Indiana as Farm Bureau Insurance and you.
It's official. John Deere tractors set 7 new performance records in the Nebraska test, including the most fuel-efficient tractor ever tested. Get a good deal on a new John Deere 105 to 200 horsepower tractor and put this record-setting performance to work on your farm today.
See your nearby Indiana John Deere dealer.
In that first quarter of play, leading scorer for Concord's Minutemen, Jamar Johnson with 8. For Bedford North Lawrence, Damon Bailey with 11.
There's Bailey's drive on the last sequence down court, and he gets that ball off the board exceedingly well.
Bedford's average winning margin in tournament play has been almost 15 per game, 14.6. And Concord's average winning margin, 18.1. So when they win big. A change to the BNL lineup. That is Paul Stevens, a 6'2 senior, number 30 with the basketball.
There's the setup again. Bailey tries to go cross court with it. He had the one-on-one with an open court to his right. But Ken Osuera figured that one out very quickly, made a nice steal.
And we'll see how Concord adapts. And we get the three at the other end. That is Jeff Massey.
Massey showing a little more range there than we anticipated he might have. They had Curry bottled in the corner there with that press momentarily, but he gets away from it.
So the Leafs cuts out at 24-21. Bedford North Lawrence at the other end. I tell you, the shooting is pretty hot right now, Tom. They've got Bush now with 5.
Alan Bush at 5'10 and Dwayne Curry at 5'9. Little kids in there in that backcourt, and they're really doing a nice job. Swanson tried to take Curry inside. The bigger man, 6'3", shooting over him. He couldn't get it to fall, but we do have a foul on the rebound effort. There are the first quarter stats. 75% shooting from the field for Bedford North Lawrence. They've taken 4 fewer shots. Perfect from the free throw line. rebounds, even at four turnovers. Stars have turned it over five times to Concord's two.
A foul, by the way, on Jason Lombrick, his first of the game. 7 minutes, 10 seconds to play. Second quarter, beautiful turnaround shot right at the free throw line by Massey. So Jeff has come up with 5 points in the first 56 seconds of the second period, and he has shot Concord right back in this ball game. 26-23, they were down by half a dozen points just a couple of minutes ago.
Okay, their team balance offensively is one of the things that really makes them shine. They had Micah Sharp come through big this afternoon, and Jeff Massey bringing him back into it here in the second period tonight.
Well, they had five players in double figures, and that's one of the keys to their success. Alan Bush, young man penetrated the lane. He has all four of Bedford North Lawrence's points here in the second period.
Second leading scorer on their ball club, but coming off the bench is their sixth man.
6.5 minutes to go in this first half. Reach in foul, right smack in front of the official, but is it on somebody away from the ball?
I think it's on Paul Stevens, but we'll check.
Well, he was the guy that we thought was guilty, but the outside official made the call.
Well, it is going to be on Stevens. You see, he's coming around number 30, Jeff Massey, and has him on the arm. They're going to the hot man. It's Ben Massey, and they try to get it to him low. Asoera and Hackworth go out, and Micah Sharp and Bill Mutch return to the lineup.
Okay, Jamar Johnson will toss it in. He does that long range to Massey. And they got it back into Johnson. That's a set play right from the inbound.
It's another inbound situation, which they've been so adept at handling, and they had a bad match for Bedford's concern that time. Good for Concord.
Here's a steal by Jamar Johnson. It's up, and it's good in the final game in Bailey. The first on Bailey, and Jamar Johnson now with back-to-back hoops and 12 points in the game has pulled Concord back to within three. Look at this again here.
Well, he's going to make the steal here from Dwayne Curry. See, Curry's trying to protect the ball, kind of lost his balance, went down as he was doing so. Jamar picked it up. Bailey makes contact with him. The basket's good, and Johnson will go to the free throw line. He is an extremely mature athlete.
Jamar is headed for the University of Nebraska. On scholarship, majoring in either business or law enforcement. Intelligent young man.
Well, we have a tie ball game, and Jeff Massey's going to be whistled for a foul on the sideline. A little bit over anxious in their press. It's going to be very difficult to press Damon Bailey with that part of the court. And Jeff tried to cut him off and was unable to do so.
Concord and Bedford locked up at 28 for the state high school basketball title. This is Johnson coming up right in the face of Damon Bailey to pick him up at three-quarter court. Well, that leaves somebody open, and there that somebody is. Long range shot rims and comes out of there by Alan Bush. And here comes Concord again. They don't have the numbers to get the three. Rolls comes out, rebound Bailey, looks for the outlet pass, finds it on the near side. This is Stevens to the hoop and scores.
Well, there was a nice run by Bedford North Lawrence. They will take that fast break when they get the opportunity, and the defense was broken up that time. They had the open court, and Paul Stevens laid it in on a pass from Damon Bailey.
5.5 minutes to go in this first half. The pace about what you expected, Tom?
Pretty much so. Bedford North Lawrence being fairly cautious, but they're going to take the break when they get it, and they had a couple of opportunities, and there's a kick. Swanson. Well, they never did get in sync on that offensive set, and he couldn't handle the ball, finally kicked it out of bounds.
All Swanson was trying to do was turn a disaster into something positive, because it was not his fault that the play broke down in the first place. He just couldn't get there.
A little bit surprised to see Johnson going one-on-one here with Bailey.
Here is Bailey. Double pumped it, and he is fouled. We talked earlier about keeping the Stars off the free throw line. We had a very strange thing happen today as that foul is on Massey. The Bedford North Lawrence Stars beat Southport 58-55. They went one entire quarter and 36 seconds of the previous quarter and didn't score a field goal. They did not score a field goal in the entire fourth quarter of that game. Tom, I don't know if I've ever seen that before.
Well, it's an unusual situation, and particularly for a team to win and be able to get by with that.
But they were at the free throw stripe. They were very effective from that free throw line, and they got the job done. Bailey did not have a really good day at the free throw stripe earlier today. He was 9 of 12. That's not good by Bailey's standards. Now he's 0 for 1.
No, the team missed four free throws, and he missed three of them.
He missed both of them here. He is now 9 of 14. We're inside 5 minutes of the first half. Bedford North Lawrence with a 2-point lead. The game has been tied twice at 8 and 28. No lead changes. Bedford North Lawrence has led right from the get-go by as many as 6 points. Posted down low, much up and good. Will it count? And the foul is against Bedford North Lawrence. Concord with great ball movement and also good player movement that time, and they were able to get much on the baseline. The basket is going to count. Here you see Lombrecht trying to cut him off, but Bill Much, very determined, goes up with it on the line, and he hits it. That was on Curry, I guess, not Lombrecht.
That's on Curry.
And that's strange because Curry is only 5'9", but that happened earlier today. He has no fear of going in there.
Well, he was trying to help out his teammate that time, Lombrecht, who Much was able to pivot around and get up strong.
Those are Much's first points in this game tonight. He is the leading rebounder. That is the first lead change. The first time Concord has had a lead. It is at 31-30 right now with 4 minutes and 35 seconds to play. 40,000 plus on hand of the Hoosier Dome. They'll give us the official figure. It'll be somewhere around 41,000, much like this afternoon. In fact, all the seats were sold, so even if they're not in their seats, that's been paid for. Alan Bush penetrates. He is fouled and really almost got the shot away.
Yeah, he got Swanson off his feet, and that was the final blow for Mike Swanson in that situation. Here we see Alan Bush, the sophomore, dribbling with a left hand, fakes. There's Swanson up and over him, and now it's just a matter of contact, which he made. Bush was unable to get the basket, but he'll go to the line. Alan Bush been a pretty good free throw shooter as the entire club this year. His first one tonight, Tom. He was 0-for-0 earlier today. He did not go to the free throw stripe, and he's got both of these. So Bush is having a pretty good second quarter. He had 3 on 1 3-point field goal in the first period. He has 6 points here in the second quarter, and another lead change. It goes back to Bedford North Lawrence, 32-31.
Kind of a passive pressing defense that time by the Stars. Go to the wing and then deliver it inside. Go to Much. Can't handle it. And a steal at the other end that's created that time for defensive efforts of Chin Asuera. He has the basketball right now. Johnson with a little one-on-one. He's got Cummings out there to face him. Now gets the ball inside. The fallaway shot is short. The rebound comes down to Jason Lombrecht with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to play in the first half.
Now here's a real battle between two outstanding players. Johnson guarding Bailey right here.
Here's the long-range shot by Bush at the other end, off the mark, rebounded by Asuera. Oh, they hit on the near side. Micah Sharp wide open. Here it is, thrown away. Sharp came down the right wing. I don't think anybody saw him, including his own teammates. Now that full court pressure with 3 minutes and 22 seconds to play in this first half. Bush has come off the bench for his father and done an excellent job in the second quarter.
There's a place for the little man in the game.
Well, there is today. Rebound, walking violation, turn out against Bedford North Lawrence. Tom is talking about the place for the little man. The tallest of the four starters in here today, Anderson, Southport, Concord, and Bedford North Lawrence, the tallest starter on any of those four clubs was 6'4". The tallest reserve on any of those clubs was 6'6". It is one of the smallest Final Fours, Tom, I can ever remember.
Well, they've been pretty good ball handlers for the most part, and some good three-point shooting, which makes that a little more valuable. If you can do those things, you don't have to be maybe quite as tall.
He's not taken away from the play of the game whatsoever. 2 minutes, 44 seconds to play in this first half. It is Bedford North Lawrence leading by one, 32-31. This is Cummings with the basketball. Stevens and Damon Bailey rebounded by Mike Swanson. Concord hurrying it up court, and Bailey kicked it out of bounds. Nice defensive play by Bailey, and a timeout has been taken. Our scoreboard clock shows 2 minutes and 28 seconds to play, and Bedford North Lawrence still up by one, 32-31. One of your network sponsors is the American Dairy Association of Indiana.
Everybody knows that milk's for babies, so charming, disarming, whatever they do. Everybody knows that milk's for babies, and wouldn't you know it, baby, milk's for you. Soft baby skin, strong baby bones, bright baby smile, and great muscle tone. Wouldn't you know it, baby, milk's for you. It's a healthy baby.
When you think about it, there are a couple of things that get Hoosiers wild-eyed and crazy faster than anything else. Basketball is number one. It's called Hoosier hysteria for good reason. The second thing is saving money, and H.H. Gregg is perfect at that. During Gregg's Hoosier Hysteria sale, this cable-ready 41-inch Magnavox stereo big-screen TV with universal remote and free delivery is only $16.99. Shop Gregg's Hoosier Hysteria sale today. The savings will bring you to your feet.
Mike Swanson wants to get the ball up court for the Minutemen of Concord, as we see right here. Going to look for Micah Sharp. Throws the ball on the inside of Micah, you see, rather than the outside. That enabled Bailey an opportunity to get his hands on it, but ultimately it went off his foot and out of bounds. Concord is shooting 14 of 24, Tom, for 58%.
Pretty good, huh?
Not good enough, because Bedford North Lawrence is shooting 12 of 19 for 63%. So both ball clubs really on their mark at this juncture of this basketball game, which has 2:27 to play. Concord wearing the white uniforms. They got the basketball down by 1 point, 32-31. Micah Sharp, out of Swanson. This is the guy they got to get in the game, Tom. Bill Mutch, he has only 3 points so far. He was a pretty good ball player this afternoon. Swanson, and a 3 second lane violation called on Jamar Johnson. Well, that's an unusual violation. The Minutemen do not turn the ball over very often on things that are fundamental in nature. And this is an opportunity now maybe for the Stars to pick up another basket before the half. 2 minutes to play precisely. Damon Bailey directly in front of our broadcasting vantage point. This is their first trip to the Final Two in the history of the school. They've been to the Sweet 16 a half a dozen times, but they've never won this thing, never gotten this far.
No, we're going to have a new banner of state champion in some community after tonight.
Tapped away belongs to Concord, as both these clubs looking for their first state championship. In fact, Concord has been to the Sweet 16 three times, Final Eight twice, Final Four twice, and this is their second trip to the Final Two. They lost to Muncie Central 76-53 and 88. Sean Kemp, 23 points, 13 rebounds in that game, but just wasn't enough. Final minute and a half to play with Concord down by one. They lob it backdoor to Mutch. That's the guy we told you we thought had to get in the ball game for Concord to be successful. That lob is a very effective lob. This is a good passing ball club.
Well, they set it up nicely by the way they rotate the ball to the opposite side. And Mutch makes a couple of steps like he's coming to meet the ball from the opposite wing. And the defender takes a step into there, and they lob it back and over the top. But he really starts the ball a little bit low to go up very strong right there. Had he had that ball up stronger, he might have been able to pick up a couple of baskets. But instead, he's going to have to go to the free throw line.
Well, Mutch is one of the guys that started as a sophomore on that club I was just talking about. They got to the state finals a couple of years ago. He's quite a baseball player. He's going to attend college on a baseball scholarship. He has not yet decided where that college is going to be. But a guy like that, I think he could probably throw one right through you. He gets the two free throws. Bill is 3 out of 3. 5 points for him. And another lead change. That's the third of the game, with Concord now in front 33-32. That's Bush on the far side in the middle, deflected away, and out comes Jamar Johnson. It's 2-on-1. Johnson behind his back, and that time just too fancy for his own good. He had Jeff Massey on the left side, and he had Micah Sharp as a trailer. I don't think Sharp had any idea it was coming that way.
No, his best alternative is take the ball to the basket
right to
that time.
Final 1 minute and 3 seconds of the first half. Bailey now in a little zone trap. Had it deflected away, but right back to him by Jeff Massey. Here is Bush on that left baseline. He's been tough from there. Hits the bottom of the backboard, and out of the traffic comes Mike Swanson. Here comes Concord again. The open man is Sharp. Sharp takes the shot and got it.
Oh, what a day he's had. Micah Sharp connecting on the break. That was a big basket right there.
And that is the biggest lead of the game for Concord at 3, 35-32, 35 seconds to play in the half. They're still not paying any attention to Alan Bush, who is wide open on the left wing. Now he goes out to the free throw line, now goes down to the baseline.
He's hard to see over there,
Jerry. Well, I guess that's true, too. That's a good point, Doc. 22 seconds to play. Inside. Long break. No. Again, no. And a whistle underneath. And the foul may be on Jason. And if it is, that is 3.
Well, they had the ball into him very nicely. He had room to maneuver and had an opportunity to take that shot, and does pick up his third foul with only 19 seconds to go in the half.
So he will get out of there in a hurry and go sit down with the coaching staff of Bedford North Lawrence. Jason Lombrick
with 2 points, and that came on a first quarter field goal. He's not all that prolific a scorer. He had only 6 earlier today. He averages 9-2, and there he was, sitting next to head coach Dan Bush. We'll get another change now for Concord. They'll put Donnie Hackworth, their 6'2 sophomore, back in the lineup, and he'll replace Jeff Massey. And Bill Mutch goes back to that free throw strike. Big points here. Biggest lead that Concord has enjoyed in this championship game, 35-32.
Well, Concord now with 18 points here in this second quarter at this particular juncture, and the Stars have tallied but 8. Concord by 4, and Mutch will have another free throw. Oh, he's been right there.
He is 5 for 5, and the club is 6 for 6, and the lead now is at 5 at 37-32.
See the clock in the lower right-hand portion of your screen ticking down.
Let's see if they try to get the ball back outside. Here's Bush with 3. Off the mark. Rebound comes down to Concord. They've got an open man up court. Can they get it there? Here's the shot. It's good if it goes. And it's way off the mark. You can see the eyes that time of Donnie Hackworth. Did a good job looking at the scoreboard clock here at the Hoosier Dome. And he got the shot away sufficiently in time, but to no avail. So that's it. We've come to the first half of the championship game for the Boys State High School Basketball Championship in Hoosierland. The score at halftime is Concord 37 and Bedford 32. Sponsors is Indiana Bell.
Sometimes getting in the last word can mean so much and cost so little.
Hello? I just got your letter. And you called to get in the last word.
I called to say I'm sorry.
Why do we always fight?
We've been doing it for 40 years. We're good at it.
Maybe that's just what sisters do.
That and
makeup.
Do it now. Not so long distance with Indiana Bell.
It starts out as just a game. A kid with a ball passing time. But a special few realize it's more than a game. It's a dream. And becoming the best is everything. These few we call All-Americans. On April 15th, they come to Market Square Arena to take their shot at the dream. McDonald's All-American High School basketball game. The stuff dreams are made of.
Competition. For most of us, it's a word that brings sports to mind. But this is a different kind of competition, the kind that brings learning to minds. A competition for scholastic excellence. Like youth sports programs, the goal of the Academic Super Bowl, sponsored by Indiana Bell, is to give young people the chance to shine. It's an opportunity for them to sharpen their skills and talents through teamwork and training, so they can go out into the world with confidence and excel. In the coming year, over 40,000 Indiana students will take part in activities presented by the Indiana Secondary School Administrators. These events, from spelling and speech contests to debate and music competitions, all help to bring out the potential in our youth. Whatever the competition, we encourage you to get out and give these young people your support, because they're all winners.
For the presentation of finalist awards to the 2 state finalist teams eliminated this afternoon. Presenting the state finalist medals to members of First Anderson High School will be Gerald Yentis, principal of Greensburg High School, and Daniel Howell, principal of Fort Wayne Northside High School, members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee. First to Jason Townsend. John Potts. Maurice Fuller. Frank Morgan. Brad Townsend. Troy King. Rob Williams. Sean Perry.
Sean, you were in the elevator with me the other day.
Jamie Horton. Vince Tatum. Tyrone Kelly.
One more.
Terry Fuller.
Terry, right here.
Assistant coach Dick Maynard.
Congratulations, coach.
Assistant coach Bill Thomas. Athletic director Jack Macy. Head coach Norm Hill.
Well, congratulations on a great season.
And principal Horace Chadbourne. And now to present the medals to members of Southport High School will be Larry Gambiani, the superintendent of Rockville Community Schools, and Larry Pinkerton, the principal of Plymouth High School, members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. First, Vaughn Williams. John Springer. George Campbell. Shotgun Land. William Moore. Dan Von Dillingham. Stephen Parker. Brandon Corky. Marlon Fleming. Manager Jason Collins. Manager Brian Robinson. Assistant coach Jim Compton. Assistant coach Bruce Cal. Assistant coach Mark Fletcher. Head coach Bill Springer. Athletic director Chuck Robbins. And principal, Dr. Lloyd L. Boldy.
It's a great honor for me, too.
Ladies and gentlemen, a warm round of applause for these two outstanding state finalists for 1990.
Congratulations to the Southport Cardinals and the Anderson Indians. Earlier today, the Project XL champions were honored for their anti-drug messages. And tonight they're all sitting together. Again, congratulations to Molly Ann Stout of Pendleton Heights, Christy Lytle of Floyd Central, Jeff Ray, Darren Hudson, and Josh Regan, all from Eminence, Monty Persinger and Justin Nearman of Brownstown, Cher Brown of Pike Central is there, and Kevin Court and Steve Hurst, both from Floyd Central. Congrats again. Nice work, gang. All right, halftime score again is Concord 37, Bedford North Lawrence 32. We'll be back in just a minute. Let's pause for these messages.
It's the most eagerly awaited driver's sedan in Pontiac history. Four-door functionality charged with Grand Prix style, performance, and driving excitement.
Get on the Pontiac and ride! Pontiac ride!
Look it over. Check it out. Try it on. The new Grand Prix sports sedan. At your Pontiac dealer now.
Rebuild excitement! Pontiac!
Hills has the right stuff.
You got the right stuff, baby.
Like New Kids on the Block.
T-shirts.
Nightshirts. Fun stuff. Hills has New Kids on the Block. Cassettes, CDs, and videos. All priced low every day.
Concord leads 37-32 at halftime. We have distinguished guests with us. This is Bryce Durbin, and he is the executive director
of the National High School Athletic Associations around our great country. Bryce, it's good to see you back in Indianapolis. You get back here rather often.
Oh, yes, quite often. And to come back for an occasion like this is something you'll never forget.
Well, you've had your association have its national dinner here.
That's correct. We've had several national meetings here. Of course, never anything quite like this, though.
Tell me about your reaction to the Hoosier Dome and the caliber of basketball we're having here today.
Well, I think, Indiana's always had tremendous basketball. But when you come and see it in front of a crowd like this and the people in Indiana responding like this, then you see the kids play like there's not over maybe 300 or 400 in the crowd. It really is impressive.
The basketball around the United States, though, is in tremendous popularity.
Oh, yes, very much so. And the kids are getting better. They're quicker, they're better coached. In fact, high school basketball is just—it's moving right on up.
Well, Bryce, great to see you. Congratulations on the tremendous job you do. Best
Thank you very much,
Bryce Durbin, Gene Cato, the distinguished commissioner of the association, and Gene, tremendous crowds. I'm sure that your expectations have been fulfilled.
Certainly they have. I told someone between sessions, one of the most beautiful sights that I've seen in my life was to see a full house in here about 11 a.m. this morning.
Not only have you had great crowds here, but the basketball, the competition is brilliant.
We've had two outstanding basketball games this morning, and this one has every indication that it's going down to the wire.
Are you going to give any consideration to coming back here?
Oh, we will give a great deal of consideration, and this is a decision we hope to make at the end of June.
Congratulations to you. A wonderful organization that's gone well.
Thank you, Hillier.
Thank you. Gene Cato, and now let's go back to Jerry Baker.
Well, the halftime score is still Concord 37, Bedford North Lawrence 32. We'll be back at the second half tip-off in just a moment. One of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance.
As much a part of Indiana as saying hello at the end of the day. Roses pushing baskets on a roadside stand, a cup of coffee at the corner cafe. There is much a part of Indiana as Farm Bureau Insurance and you.
I'm not Kuppenheimer, but wearing one of his great-looking all-wool suits is always good strategy. I'm not Kuppenheimer, but when it comes to shirts, ties, and accessories, this is a major league place.
I'm not Kuppenheimer, but when it comes to making me look good, no one manages it better.
Well, I am Kuppenheimer, and when it comes to great suits at great prices, I'm the best game in town. Kuppenheimer, America's number one value clothier for men.
Here are your first half statistics, Tom Eschen.
Well, excellent shooting by both clubs. Not a lot of difference in the statistics until you get down to the three-point field goals, and that's 9 points difference in the ball game. 4 of 8 for the Stars. Concord only 1 of 4. Rebounds, turnovers, virtually even.
Halftime scoring, Damon Bailey had 11 points, but none in the second quarter. That's interesting. He missed his only 2 free throw attempts in that second quarter, so he has to turn it on here in the second half. You see that Bush also had a good first half. Jamar Johnson, right on target.
Well, he's the quality star of the Minutemen, and you expect him to have big nights. Sharp, another senior with 8 points. And there's the scoring. Nobody in personal foul trouble for Concord.
Also interesting to note, we talked about how Damon Bailey had a good afternoon. Here it comes, the play where he deflects the ball away and makes good defensive efforts also.
Good hands, good instinct for the basketball game, which we've observed in this state the last several years. Watch him go to the left hand and lay it in.
Soft touch. His counterpart on the other side of the stadium tonight has been number 22. That's Jamar Johnson, who finishes up the first half with 13 points. He's been very effective. And here he is right here, as a matter of fact, on a good defensive effort, and gets the little 10-footer right out front. So Johnson leads the scoring with 13 for the Concord Minutemen. We'll be back with the second half tip-off in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is the American Dairy Association of Indiana.
Now you cannot fit 2 of me in this dress. And I've got big news for you, big brother. I'm drinking milk.
And in the next few years, it's going to give me a lot of what I need for strong bones, beautiful skin, and a healthy body. Before you know it, I'll be turning the heads of your friends.
And when I do, if you're still the same little creep in a big body,
I won't even acknowledge you're my brother.
Milk
It does a body good.
Jazz party's in less than an hour.
You gotta hurry.
Need lots of delicious food in a hurry? Try the Deli Bakery at Marsh.
We'll have potato salad,
a quart of baked beans,
barbecue ribs,
fried chicken.
Oh, slices extra thick, please.
He likes yeast donuts with glazed icing.
Or is it cake donuts with chocolate icing?
Let's get both.
At the Marsh Deli Bakery, there are no surprises, except the ones you plan. You value the Marsh Deli Bakery, and we value you.
With Hilliard Gates and Tom Heshen, this is Jerry Baker. We're back live at the Hoosier Dome. 41,000 on hand. They watched the good first half of basketball with Concord leading Bedford North Lawrence 37-32 for the state championship. Turnovers are interesting, but maybe what's more interesting is what you do with those turnovers once you get them. The turnovers were very similar in the first half, but Concord doing a good job of turning them into points at the other end.
That's right, and it becomes sometimes a meaningless statistic unless you are able to capitalize on it.
Second half basketball will belong to the Minutemen of Concord High School, Concord located way up north in Elkhart, Indiana. They are unbeaten in 28 ball games coming into this championship affair. They go down to Bill Mutch. He loses it out of bounds, but last touch by Bedford North Lawrence. And that's one of the things, Tom, we thought might happen earlier in this ball game to force the ball into Mutch, but that's not been the case so far.
Well, I think Jim Hahn would like to do that, and they have, on several occasions, made an effort, but it's just not easy to get that entry in there. And when they do, Mutch is really surrounded and not much room to work.
We're just getting underway now in the second half of this ball game. Here is Jamar Johnson. Ball away shot comes out of there. Bailey's got the rebound.
They look like Bailey just threw Jeff Massey right off the floor that time.
I think Massey thought he did too. And Johnson makes the steal. It ends up in the hands of Massey and given right back to Jamar. Good defensive effort by the Minutemen of Concord. Nice fake on Bailey, and Damon's got the personal foul. We were talking earlier in our telecast about how Bedford North Lawrence did not score a field goal in their final quarter against Southport today. They hit 15 free throws. But Tom, John Osler, who does our statistical work for us, tells me that BNL went the final 4 minutes, 18 seconds of the first half without scoring at all. So they've hit a dry spell.
Some real dry spells there. Swanson had a nice shot but couldn't get it to fall, and Bailey has the rebound.
And, of course, they still have not scored here in the second half. Here comes Bedford North Lawrence. Damon Bailey, by the way, continues to move up that ladder. Here's a near steal out long range. He is now third all time in scoring.
Well, add two more to that number as Bailey gets the first two for Bedford here in the second half.
He has just passed Oscar Robertson of Christmas Addicts, who had 237 points in Sweet 16 career scoring. Bailey is now up with 13 points to 244. 6:41 to play in this third period. The shots are so close, but yet so far for Concord. They have not gotten the rolls very well.
No, they have gotten good shots the last two times down. The ball's been hanging on that rim, but coming off on the Bedford side.
Now let's see what's happening to Bailey. Jamar Johnson still has him. In fact, that's him, 22 right in his face. He goes wherever he goes. Here's the three, short. Rebound on the floor, picked up by, well, a good tap away by Jamar Johnson. Nice thinking that time on Jamar's part.
Well, the outside defenders were really screening away very deep, and nobody was in position to get to that ball until it took a bounce or two.
6:06 to play. They lob it to Mutch. He lost it, and it belongs to Concord.
Mutch has the ball knocked out of his hands quite a few times inside there. I don't know whether he's I still think he's going too low of a starting position.
Here's
get the ball up higher.
He is being defended by Jamie Cummings. Now here's Mutch out high. Well, there's a mad collision under the hoop down there. Here's the outside 15-footer that's off the mark, and the rebound comes down to the smallest guy out there, Dwayne Curry.
Well, Sharp did not give that ball much of an opportunity to go through. Not necessarily a bad shot, but he's a little bit better off when he's squared up to the hoop rather than on the move.
Bailey singled out one-on-one. Can't get into the hoop. Got himself a little trouble in the three-point or the three-second area. Now gets the inside turnaround pass to Chad Mills.
Nice three-man game. Bailey twice couldn't go. Had Cummings as an outlet, and when they stepped outside, Mills stepped in. Got the pass and put it up there.
Picked up the defensive pressure. Likewise, Dwayne Curry and Chad Mills coming out right on the guards of Concord. It's a 37-36 lead now for Concord.
William Moore of Southport knows what that feels like. And Dwayne Curry, even though only 5'9", he weaves his way through traffic, and there he is right in Swanson's face.
Dropped it inside to Mutch, and there's the score. And the way the Concord bench exploded, you got to feel that that's one of the things they talked about at halftime. They're very good on two-on-two basketball. 4 minutes and 43 seconds to play in this third quarter. 39-36 Concord. Bailey, yes. Well, he got the step on Jamar Johnson down that baseline, and that's all he needed. Up in the air and the soft, feathery touch that time. Bailey has now scored 40 points today. He had 25 this afternoon. He has 15 so far tonight. Much threw it away. Well, Much got down to that baseline. There were a lot of bodies down there. I don't know what he was trying to do. I guess bullet pass down that baseline. We'll take a look at it again. Maybe he'd been better off going right to the hoop on the shot.
Well, he wanted to avoid the charge. Yeah. He thought he saw Micah Sharp, but Micah's hands were not quite up in position to handle a pass that had a little zip on it.
And he just really caught Micah completely unawares. 4 minutes and 22 seconds to play in this third period. Concord leading by one, 39-38. They have been behind by as many as six. They have led by as many as five. We've had two ties, one way back at eight, the other at 28. And here's the foul as Bailey starts to go to the hoop. And they will put the personal foul against Concord, and it's on Jamar Johnson.
Now, Jamar came along the baseline side. Let's take a look at it again. There's a move to the right, pass low to Bailey, and Jamar comes, as we said, along the baseline side, kind of incidental contact, but he did make contact.
4:13 to play, third period.
Wombrek gets it inside. Swanson wanted to draw the foul, but no whistle. Not a lot of contact right there. And big basket for the Stars, putting them on top by one.
That's that same three-man play you were talking about a while ago, Tom. They just moved it down to the right side. They run a little triangle pattern very, very effectively.
Both defenses are working extremely hard, and you really have to make some good moves and cuts in order to get in a position to get the pass. That's going to go against Jamie Cummings, and the Bedford fans are not going to like that one.
That is the third on Jamie. And what happened was, well, take a look at it again, and you'll see what's going to happen, especially away from the ball. Now, there's the play at the other end. Okay, now here's what we're talking about. I don't know if we'll see it or not, but here, right here, watch 44. Boom, there's the collision, and there's the arm wrestling. Yeah. That was actually away from the ball at that time. And the ball went against Bedford North Lawrence, and as we say, the third on Cummings.
Coach Jim Hahn up wants a particular offensive set right here. Let's see what we're going to get. Going to get Much coming up and taking the pass from the wing, and he was open for the shot.
Well, it looks now, Thomas, so maybe they have moved Much out a little bit from underneath the hoop to get the ball to him. Or
yeah, they want to get something established down there so they can get a little room outside for Swanson and Jamar Johnson to do some shooting where they are best suited to do it.
We've just had our fifth lead change. Here is Bailey trying to make it six, and he does.
Well, that was a reversal back to the top of the circle where Bailey had the right side of the floor cleared out for him, which Bedford uses quite often. And when he gets the opportunity, he usually can beat one defender, and that time he weaved his way through a little bit of traffic.
Bailey has 17. Ball tapped away by Dwayne Curry. And a timeout has been taken. 2 minutes, 55 seconds to play in this third period for the state championship. Bedford has grabbed the lead by one, 42-41. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell.
Sometimes, even when you're going out, you don't want to be out of reach. Call forwarding can help. By pushing three buttons, then dialing the number where you can be reached, your calls will be automatically forwarded there. Perfect when you've got a big date on the same night you're expecting a big call from your boss.
This is probably for you.
Call about call forwarding.
Hello, Alan.
Hi, boss.
Because sometimes you don't want to be out of reach.
Not much. You know.
The American farmer takes on a lot of tough jobs every day. He does everything he can to produce a good crop. And he does everything in his power to preserve our delicate environment, such as terracing his fields to control runoff and erosion, so that families like his can continue farming for generations to come. Brought to you on behalf of the American farmer by the makers of Dual Herbicide.
This is C.M. Phillips. He officiated this tournament in 1945, 46, and 49. He's from Greencastle, Indiana. He has seen 62 consecutive state championships. Is that
yes,
right?
That's right. I've seen 62 consecutive, every minute of them. However, some folks might have said
I missed parts of the three officiating.
Never. How do you like the officiating here tonight?
Oh, it's fine. I've never seen an official make a mistake yet.
Congratulations to you. Back to Jared.
Thank you, Hilliard. 2 minutes and 55 seconds to play in this third quarter. It is a Bedford lead at 42-41. And here's a reach-in foul as they came over the top to Jason Lombrick. And if it's on Jason, I've got him for four.
Well, that's four, and his coming in to start this quarter lasted 12 seconds, and he's going to go back to the bench as Paul Stevens will be his replacement. He got a little over-anxious that time, thinking he was going to be able to go all the way around much and deflect the ball away, and all he did was make some contact.
The inbounds pass now with Concord in command of the basketball and trailing by one. Sharp, one-on-one against Damon Bailey. Outside shot right on the three-point arc, taken down by Bailey. Lead pass up court to Curry, almost stolen, but Dwayne with good hands. Well, they had an open man on the near side, Chad Mills, but by the time they found him there, the defense had also located him. 2:22 to play, third period. Lob inside to Bailey, three white shirts on him. Damon got the shot. Well, we mentioned that Bailey was shut out in the second period. He had 11 points at halftime. He's at an 8 here in this third quarter, so he has 19. With 2:05 to play, Bedford North Lawrence has kicked the lead up to 3. Massey. Well, it looks like they're trying to find Jamar Johnson, but he is being defended and defended very effectively by Cummings. Now, there he is outside.
Well, they really worked hard to get a good shot. They're very particular in normal circumstances what shot they want to take. They got the one they wanted that time.
That ties the ball game. Time at 44. That's the third tie of this game. He is a little physical out there when the guy's trying to find himself an opening. Here's the outside shot at the other end. Did not get the roll to Dwayne Curry. Now with a minute and a half to go on this third period, here comes Concord back the other way. Baseline jumper by Sharp off the mark. Rebound taken down by Curry again. And he got an elbow or a hand or something in the throat, I believe.
Well, he's a tough little guy. Yeah, he is a tough kid. He's a good competitive backcourt man for the Stars. Been a mainstay all year, and the kids really respect him.
Here's a look from upstairs. He's a pretty smart young man. Here he is again. You see the three white shirts coming at him, and it may have been the hand. Is it Swanson? Yeah, Swanson. Curry, by the way, is an honors student. He's in the honors program at Bedford North Lawrence High School. He ranks fourth in the class of 380. He has a 4+ grade point average on a scale of 4. He's also the class president and not a bad basketball player, I'll tell you. Here's Johnson with the personal foul for Concord. Second one on Jamar.
That's a tough one in the backcourt to have your number one score pick up.
That is not enough fouls to put Bedford North Lawrence at the line.
Well, Bedford has committed 3 in this half, and Concord, that's only their second. Curry is out momentarily, and Alan Bush has replaced him.
1:10 to play in this third quarter. About a 41,000 plus looking on to the Hoosier Dome in downtown Indianapolis. Bush. Long rebound off on this side is up, and he's good, and a foul is called. And the foul is on Donnie Hackworth.
Well, Paul Stevens in the right place. They really didn't have a man or a body to check him away at all as Danny Bush's three-point effort comes off right to Stevens. Stevens pumps a couple of times. Then he goes up, and Hackworth commits the foul.
Here's a look from Don Lowe, same play. Stevens with a chance for the three-point play. He did not get to the free throw stripe in the victory over Southport today. He misses. He has 4 points. And it's a 46-44 ball game with Bedford North Lawrence leading by 2.
Talk a factor right here, but I don't think Concord's going to wait for a final shot in the period necessarily.
Asoera is number 14 for Concord in the ball game for the first time in a while. Hackworth, yes.
And he gets squared up to the basket. He is a pretty good shooter. He just needs a little more experience, a sophomore performer that I think is going to turn into be a pretty good one for Jim Hahn.
6-2 sophomore. 20 seconds to go, and Bedford North Lawrence throws it away. Concord beat Northfield 54-52 in the title game of the semi-state. That was their closest game of the year. Their average winning margin over 28 games is 21.2. They have just blown people away, but not so tonight. They're tied with Bedford North Lawrence at 46 with 12 seconds to play in the third quarter. Bailey on a steal. Nice defensive play by Damon. He'll bring it the length of the court by himself with five, with four, with three. Open man Bush bobbled it, got it away. It's partially deflected, and that's the end of the third quarter. With a score all time, 8 more minutes to decide. Hoosier history is king. It's 46-46. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance.
As much a part of Indiana as a church on a road without a name. White clouds dancing over fields of green, sharing dreams on a front porch swing. They're as much a part of Indiana as Farm Bureau Insurance and you.
I'm a hot potato MC and the fries. There's a new game, McDonald's Fries Surprise. When you buy hash browns, large or medium fries, peel off the dab and play Fries Surprise. Prizes like a 69-cent Big Mac, dude. Up to 10,000 cash, it just takes the winning attitude. Trips anywhere, Delta Airlines flies. Every time you play, you win a prize. McDonald's Fries Surprise won't last long, so hurry and play before it.
Well, the score through three quarters is 46-46. The IHSAA and the media would like to thank the cheerleader squads in Jasper High School and Couts High School for their assistance today. They have been very active in helping us do some things along Quest Row and delivering messages and info to us here through three quarters. Tom, are your numbers?
Shooting percentage is still holding up very good. Concord has not missed from the free throw line. See the three-point shooting. Rebounds pretty even. And turnovers likewise even. And we've got a pretty even ball game as we go to this fourth quarter.
Concord scored only 9 points in the third quarter. Bedford North Lawrence scored 14, and that's the reason we're tied at 46. Bedford North Lawrence possession, and ball possessions become invaluable at this stage of the state high school basketball championship. Nice defensive effort, hustle that time by Mike Swanson. Swanson had a good ball game earlier today, 11 points, 2 rebounds, 7 assists. He had 4 out of 4 from the floor. They got the inbounds pass to the open man into the hoop, and the second shot finally goes in.
Yeah, Cummings gets the basket. He had to work for it. He really took a nice pass, got himself in good position, but couldn't get the first one to fall. Jamar Johnson on the bench along with Micah Sharp right now for Concord.
That's Jamie's first 2 points of the night, by the way. Yeah, they'll try to give their big guns a couple of minutes blow if they possibly can, but if the going gets really out of hand, you can bet that Jim Hahn will have him back out there in a hurry.
Walker Backworth, he has the last two baskets for Concord. The sophomore using the backboard very well that time.
You and I talked about it earlier today, Tom. It was a time when you put a sub in the game, you expected the game to go into a trot, but they just seem to come in and just, you don't miss a beat with them anymore. Very effective, good coaching, up and down the level, right into the grades.
Top four handling it right now for the Stars, Alan Bush.
5 times our contest has been tied today. It's where it is right now at 48 with 6:55 to play. This is Mills. Deflected out of bounds by Concord.
Well, Mills thought he might be able to get up, but Hackworth right on top of the ball knocked it away and out of bounds. Check the inbound situation. They defend it low and inside.
Alan Bush. They've come out to play a little defense on him. Now it's taken away, but a foul. And it's on Asuera. Chin Asuera, 6-foot senior. Picks up personal foul number one.
Neither team into the bonus as of yet. That is the fourth team foul, however, on Concord. Now we see Alan Bush trying to get it out on the left wing, and you see Asuera has made the contact. The whistle has blown, and the ball is in the possession of the Stars off the baseline once more.
Chad Mills to toss it in. Well, they break Bush free. He gets it out of long range, so they're starting to creep up on him just a touch. He's been pretty effective, especially back in that second quarter. Here's the seal. It's Massey. He has help on the other side, trying to go to Hackworth, and Damon Bailey made the steal.
Oh, he came from a long way.
Great play.
Because he was back in the lane when that ball was taken away.
Damon Bailey, of course, headed for Indiana University. Play for Bob Knight of the Hoosiers. Here's the three, long rebound by Asuera, and a foul call. It is against Bedford North Lawrence's Paul Stevens, and that'll be number 2 on him.
Hey, most of the performers that go into the ballgame for Jimmy Hahn contribute something, and Oswalera got a rebound that time. And that's why he feels very free to substitute over there, as Oswalera now goes out. We're at the 6:13 mark in the final period. Sharp is back in. So is Jamar Johnson.
Micah Sharp comes in with a total of 8 points, but he hasn't scored in the second half. Jamar Johnson has 16, but his only second half contribution has been a three-point field goal in that third quarter. 6 minutes, 2 seconds to play in this game. They got a couple more this time as they set up Jeff Massey. Massey's one of those guys. He's a starting forward, Tom, and he can come off the bench after a rest, or he can get the open 15-foot shot and be very effective.
Well, Mutch was posted down low, and they brought Massey into the top of the circle, and he has a nice touch.
Seventh lead change of the ball game. 5 minutes, 40 seconds to play. Concord has a two-point lead at 50-48.
Massey has his opportunity now to guard Bailey. They had Swanson and Johnson on him earlier.
Bush, nice move. Well, he looked back door, tried the alley-oop. Nobody there. Here is the shot that would have counted had it gone. And a foul is called against Concord's Mike Swanson. I'm just fascinated by the fact that the lack of size on both these ball clubs, Tom, has had nothing to do with their ability to run plays that you think basically are designed for big men. Alley-oops, things of that nature. They do them very well.
Well, their execution has been tremendous throughout most of the day. And Chad Mills, a junior performer for the Stars at the line, this afternoon when you had to have him, he was up there and hit 5 of 5 and wound up with 13 points. Normally around 5 points is average.
Well, he's 3 for 3 tonight.
Well, he does shoot the ball nicely off the fingers. Good elbow position. Ball soft. Little rotation. I know against the press.
I know Dan Bush doesn't have Damon Bailey coming back, but he's got some pretty good ball players.
Oh, they'll be a good ball club.
5 minutes, 15 seconds to play in the contest. We're tied at 50. Now, this may be this way right down to the wire. Much missing, but he draws the foul from Paul Stevens. Don't forget to visit that new Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame Museum in Newcastle, opening up on Saturday, June 30th, costing $2.5 million, and it really is a shrine to Hoosier hysteria.
Well, Bill Mutch has done a good job at the free throw line this evening. He is having a little difficulty getting some field goals to fall for him. 5 out of 5, and this will be attempt number 6. Well, he has very little motion, doesn't he? His legs, very little bend in the knee.
Very solid. He has 12 points. His average is 13-9. He had 10 points, 6 boards earlier today in the victory over Anderson. Now 13. And with 5:08 to go, that Concord lead goes back to 2. They've been able to get it as high as 5. And Bedford North Orange has been ahead by as many as 6. But in the last quarter and a half or so, nobody's been anywhere near having that kind of a lead. Bailey posted down low. Can't get the roll. Got his own rebound. Had it taken away on a great defensive play by Johnson. Double team. Hooks the pass. And they couldn't hang on to it.
Hey, Jamar Johnson made a tremendous play that time. And the pass was awry, intended for Swanson. We're going to see it again down low. Bailey gets a couple of opportunities. He backs off into Mutch. Look at the hands that Johnson has displayed right here. Hemmed in. Throws the pass that's awry. And the Stars continue to have possession.
They get out on Cummings in a hurry. Now they come on the near side to Alan Bush. Chad Mills. They're looking to find somebody inside. Here is Bush, having it blocked away. Nice defensive effort by Jeff Massey. There's Jeff.
And Massey has the long arms.
Only a junior. 4.5 minutes to go in this game. 52-50 Concord. Up by 2 for the state title.
Maneuvering down underneath.
A lot of movement there. Chad Mills.
Mills. This side.
Yeah, there's Mills. And the rebound comes off to Concord's Mike Swanson.
Well, the defense just backed off of him, and he really had an unmolested layup, as it turned out.
Massey got it inside, and the foul is called, and maybe on Bailey. And that's the third on Damon.
Very little change of expression there on Damon's face. Goes the attempt, body contact. Foul number 3 on Damon Bailey. And Micah Sharp, the senior, goes to the line.
Sharp has 8 points, but the ball comes from the field. In the tonight's ball game, he was 3 out of 3 from the free throw line earlier today. Concord was 18-4 last year and never got out of a sectional.
But their JV squad was 18-2, and there's where you build your program. Halfway through the fourth period. Well, they're going to put the top of the circle. Bailey and four men down low. Mills takes the shot out of the corner and misses, and Massey, who's made some big plays throughout the ballgame,
we'll see what kind of a pace Concord may wish to implant in this basketball game. They're right in front of their head coach, Jim Hunt. Oh, nice baseline move by Massey.
A very difficult shot by Massey, but he hit it.
Pressure now full court. Never let him get set up before Bedford North Forest handles it really, really smoothly. Mills gets inside and scores.
Yeah, both teams coming up with big baskets. Each possession right now is extremely important as we're down nearing the 3-minute mark, about 3:16 right now.
Concord's up by a deuce, 54-52. Well, they brought Mutch way out high to set the pick that time on Jamie Cummings. Here is Mutch. So while he was out there, he wasn't just setting the pick. He was working his way into position to get the pass and get the shot.
Well, he rolled just right. He's back into the defensive man, allowed the pass to come to him, and he banked it in.
2 minutes and 50 seconds to play. Here is Bush on the near side. Rims comes out of there. Mutch has got the rebound. He almost was tied up by Jamie Cummings. Now here comes Concord. When did they put this thing in the refrigerator, Tom, or did they even try it?
No, I don't think they're going to try. They're going to go to the free throw line here as Cummings might have gotten a knee in the head as he tried to dive in and take that ball away from Jamar Johnson.
Fourth foul on him. Let's salute the assistants with these two ball clubs. Concord has Phil Lechleitner, Jeff Long, Bob Kolf, and Greg Stump. Here's the replay, Tom.
Well, you see Cummings leave his feet to try and get into the ball. No opportunity except the fouling.
And we'll take a break. 2 minutes, 38 seconds to play in the game. 56-52 Concord. One of your network sponsors is the American Dairy Association of Indiana.
Everybody knows that milk's for babies. So charming, disarming, whatever they do. Everybody knows that milk's for babies. And wouldn't you know it, baby, milk's for you. Soft baby skin, strong baby bones, bright baby smile, and great muscle tone. Wouldn't you know it, baby, milk's for you. It's a health kick, baby.
Turn off lamps and dilute. Sell that double-breasted suit. If it moves, make it moolah you can use. Turn your car to legal tender. Sell a hubcap, sell a fender. Place a classified ad in the Star and News. Turn that bastard into bucks. There's even cash and hockey bucks. Turn your dwelling into dollars you can't lose. Turn your pony into silver. Turn your gizmo into gold. No one brings you buyers like the Star and News.
We're back live at the Hoosier Dome. It's a 56-52 basketball game. Bedford North Lawrence head coach Dan Bush has Mark Matthews, Rick Flynn, Tom Webb, and Dave Abels as his assistants today. And to this portion of the ball game, it's Concord hitting 23 of 40 for 58%. Bedford North Lawrence, Tom, has cooled down to 47% on 21 of 45 shooting.
Now this second half, the Stars have had some problems, particularly here in the fourth quarter.
So here is Jamar Johnson. Johnson 2 out of 2 tonight. He has cooled on considerably in the second half, but he still has 17 points in 13 of the first half. I got to believe, Tom, as he gets his 18 points, that when your assignment defensively is Damon Bailey, that's going to take something away from the offensive end.
Well, that's what surprised me a little bit, that they had him defend Bailey, and he fouls him right here.
And Jamar has 3, and this lead, by the way, at 58-52, is the biggest lead of the game for Concord. Their biggest lead prior to this, obviously, was 5, and that was back in the first half.
Really not a very good play right there with a 6-point lead. You want Bedford to run the clock as much as they will before taking a shot without putting them at the free throw line with that clock sitting right at 2:31.
In Damon Bailey's high school career at Bedford North Lawrence High School, he has won 98 games and lost only 11. 20 points for Damon. In 25 points, 10 rebounds, and 7 assists in that 58-55 victory over a very good Southport Cardinal team today. 21. Now it's 58-54. Concord still leads, and the pressure comes now for Bedford North Lawrence.
Swanson trying to assess where the defenders are as he gets it across the timeline.
And then it gets the ball very wisely in the hands of Jamar Johnson. And comes back out to help out. 2 minutes, 11 seconds to play. Jeff Massey and Swanson again. Now Mutch comes out high. They got Micah Sharp in the right corner. Here is Mutch. Missed the shot. Rebound comes down in the hands of Jason Lombrick. Big miss. Inside 2 minutes. 1 minute and 52 seconds. 4-point lead, Concord. Bailey. Yes, and a foul called on Concord. Damon Bailey now has 23 points, and he is now the number 2 scorer in the Sweet 16 with 254 points.
Well, they have Damon outside with 4 men low, and that gives him much more room to operate. And he beat the defender, and the foul is going to be whistled on 44, Micah Sharp. So now the Stars are within 2, and Bailey at a free throw line with 1.
And he's got it. And that pulls Bedford North Orange to within 1. 58-57, a minute and 45 seconds to play. This has been a great championship high school basketball game, the kind you like to see, especially after the kids have already played 1 game today. A minute 35 to play. Long range to Massey. Far side, Jamar Johnson. Looking to go to Mutch, cannot. Johnson takes the shot. Missed it. Rebound long range and a foul on Jamar Johnson. That's 4 on Jamar, but that's less significant than the fact that they'll go to the free throw line at the other end.
Well, Lombard had a little bit better position that time, and that was what made the call go the way it did, although both of them had their hands on the ball. So each other players did have 4. Lombrecht with 4. Jamar now with his 4. And the junior center for Bedford North Lawrence going to the line. Hey, the defense has been great today, and Coach Jim Hahn's going to take a timeout.
Indeed he is, with a minute and 24 seconds to play. It's Concord by 1, but Bedford North Lawrence, North Lawrence going to the free throw stripe, 58-57. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell.
Remembering the good times costs nothing, but means so much.
Good old boy.
Dad, I met a boy tonight, and I think he's special.
Hello.
Hi, Dad.
Annie, I was just thinking about you.
These are the good times. Share them not so long distance with Indiana Bell.
You'll really like the seafood shop at Marsh. Marsh has a wonderful selection of fresh shellfish. Plus red snapper, swordfish, salmon, trout, whatever's freshest.
Excuse me, miss?
Oh, may I help you?
Is the fish fresh?
Like I caught it myself.
You value freshness, and we value you.
It was about a month ago, in fact it was a month ago, just a few blocks east and north of here, when Tom and Hilliard and I and all of the rest of the state of Indiana were watching the Bedford North Lawrence girls play in the state championship game. And Hilliard, to recall, in that ball game they lost to Huntington North, finished up the year 25-1, and the boys said, hey, we got to do you one better.
That's an excellent observation, Jerry, because Bedford North Lawrence should be very proud of their basketball seasons, and it was a tremendous tournament with the girls here.
But their girls won the state title in 1983 under Pete Pritchett, who's some kind of a coach. Well, the job is yet to be decided here tonight. With a minute and 24 seconds to go, the shot is missed by Bedford North Lawrence Jason Lombrick, and a foul is called on the ensuing rebound. Well, Bailey committed the foul as he was trying to get that ball off the board, but he had no position to reach in that time, as he was clearly in the possession of Mike Swanson.
Don't I recall that Bedford North Lawrence has lost their 2 games, both in overtime?
Well, they lost them both by 1 point, that I do know. And they lost to Lawrence North in the Hall of Fame game, then lost at New Albany late in the season. Well, everything becomes of special import here in the last few seconds of this game. Mike Swanson will go to the line. Now, they'll make a change. Jamar Johnson is going out, Tom, at a very critical time of the ball game, being replaced by Chin Asawera. What's the thinking there?
Well, I think Coach Jim Hahn figures we're going on the defense. Let's get a fresher man out there. When we get possession the next time on the offense, and we have an opportunity to sub, we'll get Jamar back in.
Just the free throw. Bailey's got it. It's 58-57. Concord leads by one with a minute and 15 to play.
Now they've got all four offensive men low with the exception of Damon Bailey outside with the ball. You see him against Swanson.
Going one on one. That's just exactly what he was looking for. All they did was say it's going to be him versus whomever, and he beat him. It's the eighth lead change of the contest. We've had a half a dozen ties, and another timeout has been taken. 57 seconds remain. It's Bedford North Lawrence up by one, 59-58. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance.
As much a part of Indiana as looking for a unique antique. Riding Blue River on a summer afternoon, strawberry shortcake in June. They're as much a part of Indiana as Farm Bureau Insurance and you.
Everybody knows that milk's for babies, Charmin, Disarmin, whatever they do. Everybody knows that milk's for babies. Wouldn't you know it, baby? Milk's for you. Fine baby skin, strong baby bone, a bright baby smile, and smooth great muscle tone. Wouldn't you know it, baby? Milk's for you. It's a healthy kick, baby.
Well, there's the score. There's the score. Time left. Here is Damon Bailey. Bailey now is third in all-time Sweet 16 career scoring. He has passed Oscar Robertson of Christmas on Xi. He has passed Jay Edwards of Marion. He now has a sight set on Lyndon Jones. So he is actually second all-time in Sweet 16 career scoring.
Well, at center court, Concord will put it in play. Jamar Johnson is back in.
Here's the field goal percentages. Concord has shot well throughout much of this ball game. Final 50 seconds. They are down by one. Here's the baseline shot by Johnson.
Oh, yeah, blue chipper right there, and a good shot for Jamar off the baseline.
And he wanted the basketball. Here's a guy that wants it also. Here's the blocking foul being called against Concord as Bedford North Lawrence went right at him. And the foul will be on Mike Swanson.
That is Mike Much.
Was it on Much?
That's going
54, not 34. Bill Much with his second. Here it is again. And there's Much right there. Second one on Bill.
Well, 40 seconds remain. Damon Bailey just took the ball. He was going to try and beat the defense back, apparently, and the defense was not really set, but somebody had to pick him up, and Much made the contact.
Damon in the high game this year of 42. Earlier today, he had 25. Now he has 26. Now he has 27. Somebody has one three-pointer in that 27 total.
Somebody's drawn some pretty good scripts for this tournament, haven't they?
I guess so. There's the other one. So Bailey missed his first two free throws tonight. Now has strung out five in a row. And it's 61-60, and that's the ninth and the tenth lead changes of this contest. The game has been tied a half a dozen times. Final 30 seconds of the game. Here's Massey. No. Rebound tapped up once and from behind. It may be a foul on Michael Sharp.
Now Sharp's on the back of Bailey, so Bailey's going to be the shooter.
That is the first foul of the game on Micah Sharp. The Bedford North Lawrence Stars are huddled, heard out at the other end. Now they break that huddle, and they'll make that walk to the free throw line with a critical free throw or two coming up here.
Little huddle right there among the Minutemen on the floor. Jamar Johnson is doing the talking. He's been their leader. And Damon Bailey, probably the most fabled performer in Indiana high school basketball annals in his final 24 seconds as a schoolboy performer.
Bailey has just become the fifth leading single season scorer in Indiana high school basketball history with 971 points. Looking for 972.
I think Concord has to look for the three-pointer here.
They've got 20 seconds to win or lose the state championship or at least get themselves into overtime. Here's Johnson. Rebounded by Jamar again.
Took it back out behind the arc.
Here's Massey. Rebounded by Concord again. This is Micah Sharp. Rebounded by Concord again. Here's the shot off the mark, and the ball game is over. And Bedford North Lawrence has won the state championship. Said the only thing he had left missing in his entire illustrious high school career was that championship ring, that championship trophy, and Tommy's got it.
Well, it's kind of one of those things that if you're going to spread this season over a novel or a book of any kind about Hoosier basketball, I suppose this is the way it would have turned at the end.
Writing a play, he would be the key character, and this would be the perfect finish. And there is Damon Bailey now in the crowd, and he is an honest-to-goodness folk hero, not just as a ball player, Tom, but every article I've read talks about Damon as a human being.
Well, they do, and he's going to handle this just like he's handled everything else of the successes that he has built up during his basketball career, and appreciative of a lot of people. Bedford has been a great basketball community over the years. They've had their ups, they've had their downs, but they've always loved it. And, of course, this is the one they've been looking for many, many seasons.
Well, we'll come back and enjoy some of these post-game ceremonies in just a moment. Final score again is Bedford North Lawrence 63, Concord 60. We salute the stars as the state basketball champions. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell.
Sometimes you need to talk to a couple of people at once.
Bob, Bill, how about setting a time?
And three-way calling lets you do just that.
What's Ben say?
Huh? Hold on.
With a punch of the receiver button and dialing a new number.
Ben.
Yeah.
Bob's on the line. Hold on. Ben, Bob. When do we do it, boys?
How about now?
Bob?
You bet.
Then we're in business.
Three-way calling. It helps you plan. Or change your plans.
Plan B.
It starts out as just a game, a kid with a ball, passing time. But a special few realize it's more than a game, it's a dream. And becoming the best is everything. These few we call All-Americans. On April 15th, they come to Market Square Arena to take their shot at the dream. McDonald's All-American High School basketball game. The stuff dreams are made of.
Great moment for this school of 1,705 in the southern tier of our state as the Bedford North Lawrence Stars have picked up this championship, and we're going to see the Concord Minutemen take the podium here in a couple of moments, the platform, and receive their runner-up honors. It's a tough thing to do when you've had an undefeated season. They had not lost in 28 games this year. And, Tom, they fought like champions right down to the wire before finally losing 63-60.
Well, they were well coached and obviously knew all of the circumstances. They kept getting it outside, trying to kick in that final three-pointer. Had a lot of opportunities. Bedford North Lawrence determined we're not going to foul them.
All right, let's go across and get the ceremony started with Scott Gray.
And now the presentation of runner-up medals to Concord High School. First, presenting to Ryan Culp. Matt Stender. Shane Bechtel. Phil Eddy. Colby Denman. Donnie Hackworth.
Chin Asawera. Jeff Massey. Mike Swanson. Micah Sharp. Bill Butch. Jamar Johnson. Assistant coach Bob Culp. Assistant coach Jeff Long. Assistant coach Phil Lechleitner. Head coach Jim Hahn. And principal Robert Sutton. And now the presentation of the game ball and runner-up trophy, presenting from the IHSAA Executive Committee, Mr. Daniel Howe. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1990 runner-up, the Concord Minutemen.
You guys got another year.
Well, that's a tough moment for the Concord squad and their coaching staff and their fans, but I guess there's nothing that replaces being number one, but if there is or was or could be, it would be being number two to that particular number one team.
Well, they've got a quality basketball program. They handle themselves well on the court. They do a lot of things in the basketball skill category in a very high level of proficiency. Jim Hahn, an excellent coach, and they're going to have good basketball teams for quite a while at Concord.
Now it's the Bedford North Lawrence Stars time to take their bows, and let's go back across the floor again.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, if we could clear the platform area for presentation of the championship awards to be presented by two members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Board. Presenting the awards, Dr. Larry Gambiani, Superintendent of the Rock Mill Community Schools, assisted by Mr. Gerald Yendis, Principal of Greensburg High School. And now presenting the championship medals to Bedford North Lawrence. First to Damon Bailey.
It's just a great thrill because, you know, half these people in here thought we couldn't do it. These kids work extremely hard. They're very intelligent kids. And, you know, we set a goal at the beginning of the year, not just to get here. You know, that had been our goal last couple of years. We'd got here, and that wasn't fun enough. You know, we wanted to take it all home this time.
Of all the wonderful awards that you've gotten, and you just got the James Naismith Award, all the hard work you've done, is it worth it?
Oh, absolutely. You know, this is the biggest thrill of my life. This basketball is a team sport, and those individual awards don't mean anything. These kids right here are the ones that got me the individual awards. You know, by getting me the ball in the right spots, and you know, I wanted to repay them and the town of Bedford back because, you know, there's no better fans than in Bedford, Indiana.
Damon, you got behind in the last quarter. What did you change? What did you do to get back into the ballgame?
You know, I just wanted the ball. I got confidence in my teammates, but, you know, we just wanted to suck it up, and they got me the ball in the spots where I can do something with it.
You're going to go on tour here, I understand, in a few weeks. Is that right?
Yeah, I got to go to Georgia and pick up the Naismith Award. The McDonald's is the next week, and then after that, the Derby Classic. So, you know, I'm going to take a couple of days off and, you know, try to rest a little bit. I'm going down to Florida this week for spring break, and then, you know, we're just going to get back on.
Your 1996 champion.
All right.
What a sweet victory for that ball club. The Trester Award is coming up in just a couple of moments. We'll be back and find out who that lucky young man is going to be. Final again, Bedford North Lawrence 63, Concord 60. We'll be right back. One of your network sponsors is the American Dairy Association of Indiana.
Now you cannot fit two of me in this dress. And I've got big news for you, big brother. I'm drinking milk.
And in the next few years, it's going to give me a lot of what I need for strong bones, beautiful skin,
and a healthy body. Before you know it, I'll be turning the heads of your friends.
And when I do, if you're still the same little creep in a big body,
I won't even acknowledge you're my brother.
Milk, it does a body good.
We have a corporate commitment at Marsh to eliminate lines at checkout counters. And we have a commitment to provide the customer with the best possible service. Having a person available to sack your groceries and carry them to your car is part of that commitment. Our philosophy at Marsh is very simple. You value good service, and we value you.
To the platform for the presentation of the IHSAA Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award. Presenting the award will be Mr. Don Sockel, a member of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee and principal of Floyd Central High School.
A Mental Attitude Award is presented in each of the 18 IHSAA sports. In addition to the award, Farm Bureau Insurance, the proud corporate sponsor of all IHSAA tournaments, will award a $1,000 scholarship to the General School Scholarship Fund in the name of the recipient. Before I name the winner of the Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award winner, I would invite the parents to come to the platform and share in this honor. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, leadership during the 4 years of high school, participated as a state finalist in the sport, and was selected by the members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. Now for the winner. It was unanimous. Number 32 from Bedford, David Bell. Damon, can you imagine this?
Oh, you know, this is beats everything I ever imagined. You know, we went out, we worked hard. You know, this just puts the icing on the cake here. You know, these kids, you know, we had a goal coming in. It was the Winter State Championship. We never imagined anything like this. You know, Shannon Cummings won it for the girls this year, and, you know, it was a great thrill for her. So, you know, I'm very proud.
You know, your coming college basketball coach is watching at home in Bloomington tonight. I'm sure he's extremely proud of you.
Yeah, I hope so. You know, in a couple weeks, I'll go up there. I'll talk to him. He'll tell me the things I need to work on to help IU win. You know, this season I was more worried about BNL than I was IU, but, you know, now I'm his boy.
Well, I know. Savor this, young man. You're an absolutely brilliant young man and a great athlete.
Thank you very much.
Can I see your parents?
Yes.
Are they around?
Amen.
Oh, here they are. They're just trying to get through here. What an emotional shot this is.
Damon.
Jeff
Massey. 70 years ago tonight, I was winner of this award from Bedford High School, 1920. 70 years ago, we shook hands with each other.
For Bedford,
Well, the Bailey family is now gathered around Damon. Damon was 11 of 16 from the field, including 1 out of 2 from the three-point area, 7 of 9 free throws. He had 8 rebounds, 5 assists, and 4 steals to go along with a 30-point total tonight. And, Hilliard, if you're still up there, let's go back to you. Hilliard?
No.
Go ahead.
I'm just thankful. He's worked hard, and I think he deserves everything that he's gotten.
I don't think anybody has ever worked harder, have they?
I don't think so.
Not only a state championship, but now this magnificent Presser Award.
It's wonderful.
All right. Well, congratulations
to you.
He's been a model young man from the very beginning, hasn't he? Okay, good luck to you. I know what this means. Mr. Bailey, what a tremendous thrill for you.
Thank you. That's all you can ask for.
How did you encourage this young man? What did you say to him through these years?
He'd get out of bed a lot of early mornings on all I can say. He worked hard all his life for it.
Even when he got proficient in the sport, he still got up at 6 o'clock in the morning and trained, didn't he?
Yeah, I suppose I hollered at him a few times. He done it on his own.
Are you happy you made your college selection very early and not get all the pressure here?
He wanted to do it. He done it on his own. We're happy for him.
What does he do other than play basketball and train for basketball?
Oh, softball, hunts, just hangs out like everybody else.
Were you a basketball player?
Well, nothing like this.
Nobody is like this. Nobody. Congratulations to you. Are you the sister? What is your name?
Courtney.
What is it?
Courtney.
Courtney. Are you happy?
Yes.
Have you ever had a moment like this?
No.
Did you think this was ever going to happen? Down deep inside, maybe, right?
Yeah.
Okay, congratulations to you. Thank you all. Back to Jerry.
Thank you, Hilliard. Marvelous job in some very tough circumstances. As you can see on your screen, the masses of fans are out there on the floor. A lot of those are just exactly that time. They're just fans who went out to enjoy this precious moment. We'll come back and give you a quick check on the scoring in this ball club. Concord now to 28-1 on the year. Bedford North Lawrence to 29-2 as they win it 63-60. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance.
As much a part of Indiana as a hoop hanging high on a barn. Stop along the way to brighten up a rainy day. Photographs of heroes on display. There is much a part of Indiana. Farm Bureau Insurance and you.
It's the most eagerly awaited driver's sedan in Pontiac history. Four-door functionality charged with Grand Prix style, performance, and driving excitement.
Get on the Pontiac and ride! Pontiac ride!
Look it over. Check it out. Try it on. The new Grand Prix sports sedan. At your Pontiac dealer now.
Rebuilding
They've just announced here to the crowd at the Hoosier Dome that there'll be a celebration tomorrow at the gymnasium in Bedford at Bedford North Lawrence High School at 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Will you suspect, Tom Hessian, there might be a couple of fans show up?
Well, I feel there's going to be a lot of celebrating before 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon in Bedford. It probably already started.
It may just culminate at that point in time. Quickly, here's your individual scoring. For the victorious Bedford North Lawrence Stars, Damon Bailey had 30, Chad Mills 11, 9 out of Alan Bush, 4 from Jason Lambrick, 3 from Dwayne Curry, and 2 from Jamie Cummings, 4 from Paul Stevens. For Concord,
20 points out of Jamar Johnson, 11 from Jeff Massey, 6 from Donnie Hackworth, 8 out of Micah Sharp, and 15 from Bill Mutch. And the final score again is 63-60. I'm not sure what else you can say, Hilliard. A marvelous young man who wins the Trestor Award and the state championship all in one night.
Well, the words are just not there anymore, and they weren't on the platform. They were stunned with that. I don't think Damon ever thought he'd ever get this award.
My compadre here, Tom Eschen, said that's who will get it, and he was right on the money.
Well, I have to be honest. Somebody leaked the word to me, so I got just as close as I could, and I have the source to prove it.
Good thinking. Yes, you do. Good thinking on your part. Tom, your thoughts?
Well, it was just kind of like having a nice tournament out here with a lot of teams fairly equal, choosing up sides, and whoever gets Damon wins.
Well, here we used to throw the baseball bat, and you had to hold on to the knob.
That's right.
Well, it's been some kind of a day. It really has. A record-setting day, 41,000 at the early session, 41,000 tonight. So in excess of 82,000. Gentlemen, we've been sitting in on history tonight.
Certainly have.
And our thanks, by the way, to our television crew, our technical folks, because we get to take a break between sessions. They don't get much of one. They did a marvelous job for us again today. And to all the teams who participated in the Final Four, I congratulate them also. To Anderson, Southport, Concord, and to the stars of Bedford North Lawrence High School. That's it. Jerry Baker, for Hilliard Gates, and Tom Eschen saying so long and congratulations to Bedford North Lawrence High.
You've been watching another Indiana High School Athletic Association championship event. Your network sponsors were Indiana Bell and Ameritech Company, Farm Bureau Insurance, proud corporate sponsor of all IHSAA tournament events, and the American Dairy Association of Indiana, your local dairy farmer.
Great personal service and low everyday prices. Check the lineup at your neighborhood True Value Hardware store, where the March Hardware Value of the Month is the 2-gallon...